On today's Halloween special.
It sounds scary, but can Russell Westbrook actually average a triple-double this season?
We'll play Trick or Tweet, where we guess if a tweet is coming from a celebrity or an NBA player.
And the triumphant return of Weekend Whoopsies will leave you dancing in the aisles.
It's Monday, October 31st. The starter starts now.
Good evening, sweet world! Happy Halloween and welcome to The Starters, whether you're listening to the podcast or hopefully tonight joining us live on NBA TV or catching us on YouTube later. We're happy to have you. I am Philadelphia's criminal mastermind, Jahlil Joker 4. And to my right, alongside me, as always, my arch nemesis, but the hero that San Antonio deserves, Batmanu.
My chest is so big, it's choking me.
To his right, the feline of Minnesota, taking it to the PetSmart, it's Catwoman.
Hello, friends.
Really weird. And last, certainly not least, that's the best sidekick any bat or bull could ask for. It's just straight up Robin.
Ayo!
Ayo, Robin! All right, what do you got for us?
Well, I'm here at the internet looking for your best tweets at #TheStarters. And even though we're all Batmaned up today, the past couple of years, we've been in full-on scary NBA mode. It started way back in the olden days of 2014, and that's when Skeets went as JJ Dedeck, Tass went as Bane, Wade, Lee went as Danny Scream, and I went as LaMarcus Aldridge. The next year we went retired players, Scary Payton, Tass was Chucky Barkley, Lee was Arvydas Sabonis, and I was Alien Iverson. Great times were had, we all shared a bunch of laughs, and that's why we're bringing back the hashtag Scary NBA. So hop on Twitter and let us know your best scary NBA names. It could be anything. It could be a player, like for instance, Matthew Devil Vadova. Or you could go the coach route, Greg Popovich. Or you could even go for a retired player like Brent Bonesberry, complete with his trademark salad atop his cranium. Whatever it is, let us know on Twitter. Use hashtag ScaryNBA. We'll see your best answers a little bit later.
All right, get those tweets in. Hashtag ScaryNBA. We got a fun Halloween special for you. We're going to play Trick or Tweet, the fourth annual edition of Trick or Tweet here on the show. And we have Weekend Whoopsies. But we start with Trend or Dead End. Perfect. Perfect game to play here on Halloween. Robin over there is going to throw some recent NBA developments at us. We're going to debate whether or not they'll continue. Is it a trend or is it a dead end? Robin, take it away.
That's right, Jahlil. For our first one, after back-to-back triple-doubles over the weekend, Russell Westbrook is now averaging 38 points, 12 rebounds, and 11 assists per game. It hasn't been done since 1962, but is Russell Westbrook averaging a triple-double a trend or is it a dead end?
I think it's a dead end, Robin.
Do you?
Yes, I do. It's hard to bet against Russell Westbrook, and it makes me feel stupid to bet against him because he's going to get all the opportunities in the world. The points will be there, obviously. The assists, I think they'll be there. I think he'll be 10-ish. But the rebounds, I don't think he'll get there. He's averaged 7.8 as his high in his career. Why would he get more this year? Did Kevin Durant hold him back from getting rebounds? Is he playing any less hard than he's played in years past? I think the other two will be there, but even this man is going to slow down in the rebound department.
Think
yeah.
so?
Well, yeah, they've also played the Sixers, the Suns, and the Lakers so far, who are a combined 1-7, so there's certainly more opportunity out there. He likes to go and get those rebounds because then he gets the ball in his hands and he can start triggering that offense. But he's taking 29 shots a game. He's playing 38 minutes a night. I think these are the factors that are actually going to stop him from getting it. The points will be there. He's going to get that, no problems. But the fatigue is going to catch up with him.
Yeah, how long can he shoulder this type of load just doing all this? And I'm glad you brought up the teams he's played. I mean, those three teams, they want to combine 50 games last
but
year.
Does that, matter in terms of the opportunities he's going to have? I mean, they're going to score a lot of points, but I understand they're playing bad teams. What is that going to change for Russell Westbrook? He is the center of the team. They are going to get him involved in every way.
Well, it's funny. You think it's rebounds that might sort of slow him down. Or,
yeah, because
or
it's hard for a man to get 10 rebounds as a guard.
Well,
he's only averaged seven.
He's not a man. He's not a man.
He is not a man.
Well, he really isn't. Yeah. He's a machine. But I think it's assists. Assists are interesting to me because it's not just up to Russell Westbrook in that case. It's up to his teammates as well. He needs Oladipo to knock down shots. You need, if you're going to average 10-plus assists, you do need some of those cheap ones. Where
for
you're
sure.
just sort of giving it to a guy, and he's taking a shot and scoring. So he needs your guys like Oladipo and Adams, of course, who, by all accounts, just got paid today on Halloween. That's a whole lot of candy for Steven Adams. But he needs those guys. And Oladipo's shooting 34% right now. Adams only 44%. You know, they need to obviously raise those. I think everyone would agree with that. They probably will. But he needs help. And You know, we're seeing what he's done here. It's unbelievable that he's on a list with LeBron James, Larry Bird, and Michael Jordan. I picked Westbrook as my MVP heading into this season. And you knew the numbers were gonna be like this. Like, it's sort of fun to watch this. It's just whether or not they can rack up enough wins. They need 50 plus wins, in my opinion. And then he's a hands down MVP.
Yeah, and they have had that soft schedule to start. Yeah, things get tougher a lot this week. They got the Warriors, got the Clippers a couple of times. So that's really gonna test Westbrook out. Because especially as well, if he's defending Steph Curry maybe, and Chris Paul and those sort of guys, that's gonna take a lot more energy out of him on the defensive end.
Whether or not he actually does this, how much fun is it to see whether he can actually
do it? Yeah, he's playing more minutes than he ever has in his career, but don't you think that's gonna keep up? He's not gonna sit down.
Not many coaches like to play guys though more than 35 minutes a night. He's playing 38 right now.
Yeah.
An overtime game already too. Yeah. All right, Trey, back to you. Next one.
All right, moving on. Kevin Durant is averaging 31.3 points per game through the season's first week, easily outpacing new teammate and last year's scoring leader, Stephen Curry's 25.7 PPG. Is Kevin Durant leading the Warriors in scoring a trend, or is it a dead end?
I think this is a trend.
So do I.
I think he can do this. He's averaging 31 points per game right now, and he's doing it efficiently. He's doing it in the flow of the offense. He's shooting 56% from the field. He's getting to the free throw line 11 times, where he's also 93%. And I think Steph Curry actually enjoys having someone else able to go out there, get their own shot, take a lot of the weight on the offensive end, and just give Steph. Steph said, remember at the start of the season, he doesn't care who's leading the team in scoring and who gets all the shots. And he's not. It's not like Durant's taking shots off guys anyway.
Curry is actually averaging more shot attempts per game early in the season than Durant, but it's all the free throws that Durant racks up that's going to, I think, have him winning the Warrior scoring title. Yeah. I think it is a trend.
Kevin Durant led the league in scoring without getting open shots like he is in Golden State.
For 4 years,
So I think it's pretty fair to say he's going to do it because he's a 7-footer and he can get any shot he wants. And you have to pay attention to Steph coming up the floor. That's your primary concern as a defense. All right, we got to take away the guy who can score 30 plus on us, who has the ball in his hands the majority of the time. And then you got to pick him up. You got to pick Clay up. The Warriors want to get Kevin Durant involved. They want him to feel comfortable.
Yeah.
They're a nice group of guys. Yeah. And I think they're
going to... So far, so good.
Yeah, and I think they're going to get him a lot of shots. So the number's going to be there. And like you said, that's why they signed him up. They didn't sign him up to be a third fiddle on
this
team.
Well, what do you think about Klay Thompson struggling right now? Especially from the three-point line. I believe it's 3 for 21.
Yeah.
3 for 21, Klay Thompson. Are you worried about that at all? Is that just, it will come back to normal?
I'm not worried. Last year, he started off pretty much the same way. He finished up All-NBA and an All-Star as well. So I think
this is a guy that, like, the next game could hit 8 or 9.
Exactly. And remember, he did play for Team USA as well. So his legs might be a little bit heavy at this start of the season. I think he'll be fine because you know that's what shooters are like.
He had bonkers games in the preseason, too.
Exactly.
Games,
so I think he'll be fine. But again, that, I think, helps. And that's why part of the reason why Durant's scoring more is because they're just not getting that production out of Clay yet. No need to panic, though. It'll come.
They're humans. It takes a little bit of time. Stephen Kerr said it before the season. He said it's going to take some time to work it out.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, Trey, I think we got time for one more.
All right, final one. There's some shooting in Memphis. After four threes in a win against the Wizards, Marc Gasol has 6 made three-pointers on the season, already doubling his previous career high. Marc Gasol, the three-point specialist, a trend, or is it a dead end?
Well, specialist, I think, is a dead end. I mean, whether he can knock down maybe one a game, sure, that's in play. He can hit it. It looks fine. He doesn't jump.
There's no different, really, than any of his
other shots. He can definitely knock it down. But no, he's not hitting 2 per game for the rest of the year. Not a chance.
I love it because the Grizzlies need space within the arc. It's the same story with the Memphis Grizzlies. They need to space the floor. And Marc Gasol, sort of like the Warriors, he's a giver. He passes all the time. I watch him, and I'm sure his coaches have watched him in the past and thought, shoot it, Marc.
A little more selfish.
Shoot it. Yeah. Because his first instinct is to pass. That's what he is. Mm-hmm. So I think when he gets the ball outside the three-point arc, he's not going to be guarded. I think it forces him to shoot because there is space.
True.
And I love what he said when he was asked about this. Hey, are you a three-point shooter now? He said, no. I am a basketball player. He's taking what the defense gives him. And David Fizdale comes in there and absolutely makes this a priority. It's very, very smart because this team needs as many shooters as they can.
Let's get him in the three-point shootout, I think. Do you think he'd get through all those racks?
Well,
he doesn't jump.
We've had the big man in the skills competition. Yeah, let's get the big man in the three-point competition. All right, trend or dead end? We got to take a break, guys. When we come back, man, I miss this guy. I love this guy. When we come back, we'll get the flashlights out. And we're going to go trick or tweeting. Always a blast. You're watching the Starters Halloween special. Time for our fourth annual edition of Trick or Tweet, a Halloween tradition here on the show. The game is simple. Trick or Tweet tests our knowledge of how well we know NBA Twitter accounts. We'll be read a tweet one at a time. If it's a celebrity, you say trick. If it's an NBA player, you say tweet.
Got it.
It's as simple as that. Candy is on the line. Let's see if anybody is at home. Here we go. Robin!
It's me, Robin!
Let's do it.
Let's do it. Skeets, first trick or tweet. It's ups and downs for a real one, but you'll be lame all your life, hater. Mm. Is that rapper Drake or Celtics guard Isaiah Thomas?
Whew.
Trick or tweet?
I'm gonna go tweet. That's IT.
That's IT!
Yeah, give me some
You're exactly right, my man!
Just a little gentle. Yeah, there we go.
Okay,
we
a go. Gentle one, a gentle one. All right, Tess, Batman, good to see you, my man.
Hey, pal.
Trick or tweet? I got a lot to be mad about. Is that fashion designer Kanye West or Warriors forward Andre Iguodala? Trick or tweet?
This one's easy. It's Yeezy.
I don't think so, Batman.
I thought we were friends, Robin.
We gotta work together.
Wow.
Nothing. All right, moving on. Catwoman.
Yeah. You want some Twizzler?
Trick or tweet?
Sure.
Am I the only one who feels like no president should ever say the words, I opened a club? Is that actress Lena Dunham or Bulls guard Dwayne Wade? Mm. Trick or tweet?
I'm gonna say, I think Dwayne Wade's a political guy. I'm going with Dwayne Wade.
Mm. Oh, no candy for you either.
Should've leaned the other way.
All right, Joker. You ready for another trick or tweet?
Yes.
All right, here you go. One time I wore my brother's t-shirt and my dad asked if I was dressing up as his favorite child for Halloween. Is that comedian Conan O'Brien or Bulls center and me, Robin Lopez? Trick or tweet?
That's Robin Lopez. That's you.
Ooh, sorry, you've been tricked. All right, Batman.
It's okay, have your Twizzler back.
Thank you.
All right, Batman, trick or tweet?
It's addictive.
Growing up sucks. Paying taxes, parents and grandparents getting old, a million responsibilities, driving in traffic, tough decisions, SMH. Is that actress and singer Selena Gomez or Blazers guard Damian Lillard?
That's Dame Dollar Tweet!
Yeah. That's a tweet!
Hit me!
We're back, baby! Throw that in here, you tell
it! Oh, you want some trash!
You want some more? All right, Catwoman.
Yeah.
Trick or tweet?
She doesn't like sweets.
You don't like sweets?
Well, it's not great for my hips.
I would disagree. Trick or tweet? I can't tell the difference between meditation and silent inner shrieking. Is that actor and Canadian Ryan Reynolds or Clippers forward Blake Griffin? Trick or tweet?
It's too deep for Blake Griffin. I'm going Ryan Reynolds.
That's right! Yes! Oh. Sorry, Catwoman, you're gonna have to enjoy it. All right, moving on. Our final trick or tweet, and this one's for you, Skeets.
Yeah.
Trick or tweet, shout out to all the elephants. Is that rapper Vince Staples or Lakers forward Meta World Peace? Shout out to all the elephants, every one of them.
I'm gonna go Meta World Peace.
Oh, he is the panda's friend, but that's a Vince Staples tweet right there.
Really? Wow. Shout out to the elephants, though.
Every single one, shout out to them. All right, Batman, me and you. We're in this together.
Great.
Trick or tweet. Just went in the pit at Kanye West from a B-Day. 32 is looking up. Is that singer Katy Perry or Knicks forward Carmelo Anthony?
How old's Katy Perry?
Katy Perry, 32? I say no. Carmelo Anthony, tweet.
That was a trick. That was Katy Perry.
Katy Perry.
84, great year. All right, moving on. Catwoman, our final trick or tweet. Remember when Ed Hardy clothing was a thing? 2009 was a crazy time. Is that triple threat entertainer Justin Timberlake or Clippers guard JJ Redick?
JT or JJ?
Who's exaggerating? 2009?
Yeah, JJ is a bit older than that, isn't he, really?
Like, hold on. Just to help you out. Wasn't Dwight Howard wearing a lot of Ed Hardy? JJ played with them.
Yeah.
I mean, it could come up, right?
Yeah, but I think Justin Timberlake's more a stylish dude. I'm going with JT. I want it to be JT.
You gotta trust the Joker! I guess that's all this candy for me.
Trick or tweet? The toughest yet. Man. Way to go,
Robin. Toughest yet.
All right.
What can I say?
Hopefully you did better following along at home. We gotta take a break. Lots more still to come here on the Starters Halloween special when we return. Weekend whoopsies and a wedgie. What more could you possibly want? Come on back. Back with the Starters Halloween special. We asked you earlier in the show, send in your best hashtag scary NBA names. Trey, you got a whole lot of tweets over
there. Yeah, so many. These have been great. And we'll start with this one from Emil, who goes with the classic Willy Cauley Frankenstein.
Mm-hmm. I dropped that in the top 10 last week.
Nice one. Mr. Nerdista says Uncle Fester Azili, one of my favorite dads in this family, guys. I love it. Jacob says Joel Embiid. Like it. Dean says Victor Guladipo.
Oh, that's a good one.
Yeah, that's a tough one to read, though, to be honest with you. Yeah. Ben says, how about Boo Alcindor?
Wow.
Simple.
Legend.
Throwback.
Yeah.
Mitch says Gravis Vasquez. I love it. Love it.
Gravis Caskets.
Yeah, Gravis Caskets. You've been one up, bro.
Yeah.
Jobber99 says Bat Riley. Pretty simple, but pretty funny. And the Salad Man himself, Brent Berry, says, since I've been scared off the show, I guess I'll have to find other ways to contribute. Cousins.
Man.
Thanks, Bones.
I don't know, Bones. You can do better than that.
He's a witty guy. He'll write a song about it.
That's true. All right, guys. Obviously having a blast here on Halloween, and we're not the only ones getting into the spirit of Halloween. We've seen a lot of NBA players over the last couple days and some of their costumes. A few of our favorites, Russell Westbrook as Joe Dirt.
Apparently really loves the movie.
Yeah, Paul Pierce. Paul Pierce loves Halloween. Yeah. He dressed as a frog once, and there he is as Captain Hook. That is so cute. There is his son. CJ Miles is Quail Man. Lee, do you know what Quail Man is? No? Trey, explain it for him.
Oh, that's Doug Funny's alter ego.
Do you know who Doug is, Lee?
No.
Okay. And LeBron James, he had a Halloween party. Here he is as Jerome from Martin. I mean, that is a deep
cut. That's really good.
But he is nailing it, if you remember the show Martin. And then a bunch of his Cavs teammates, that's Kevin Love and his girlfriend Kate Bock as Dumb and Dumber. That's a classic. That's great.
The teeth look awesome.
Jordan McRae as Urkel.
Wow.
Oh, it's so good.
So good.
He is nailing that. And Kyrie Irving, he just dressed as the Red Power Ranger and then just busted some moves.
He's got good moves, though.
Yeah. I don't know why he has a t-shirt on, though. Was it maybe a cold? I don't get it.
But, cold Power Ranger.
Yeah. But look, yeah, he's cooking it up. It's great. It's absolutely great. And oh yes, here's that is me on the right last week at a Yacht Rock show.
Yeah.
Yeah, you put on a Red Power Ranger costume, you gotta start dancing apparently.
Check this tweet though, coming in live right now. Robin Lopez himself tweets, but if I'm over there, Trey Kirby must be in the Barclays Center locker room right now. Hashtag audible gasp. Yeah,
that's true.
It's a good point, it's a good point. Thanks for watching, Robin. All right guys, we had a great NBA weekend in terms of action, but there were some bloopers. There were some bloopers. Time for weekend whoopsies.
Pretty special. We all zone out on the job sometimes, but when you're a security guard, it's not the greatest of things. Here in New Orleans, this guy just is totally lost.
Just play extra D.
Hey, get up!
Pull him off. Oh, yeah, he's zoned out. Saturday, it's the Bulls and Pacers. Taj Gibson gonna save it. Just chucked it up in the air. Like
straight
40
up.
Feet, what? Straight up. I watched this guy catch it in the front row. Bang, nice catch.
Nice job. Paying attention.
I just lost it.
New York got their first win Saturday, but Lance Thomas's D at the top of the key here leaves a little bit to be desired. Whoa! It's like he's playing cornerback.
He did put
wrong
his hand
sport.
Up. Yeah,
wrong sport.
It looks like a ballerina there.
Yeah.
Very nice moves. Robin Lopez talking to Bulls rookie Paul Zipser. Now, I don't know, you think he's giving defensive strategy here or talking Star Wars or something? No, he's singing Miley Cyrus's Party in the USA.
Hey, it's a party in the USA. Will Barton, he can usually throw down.
Oh.
Didn't happen there. He went for the double pump.
Yeah.
Single.
Nice jerseys, though. Weird weekend for mouth guards. First, DeMarcus Cousins. He's gonna foul out of the game here. It's his sixth foul. He thought he drew the charge, but no. He's upset. You're not gonna believe this. Cousins is upset. Takes the mouth guard.
Where's he going?
Just gonna chuck it and watch it bounce up the stairs here.
Whoa!
There it goes. Okay, he wasn't alone. Markieff Morris, watch this throw. Whoop!
Right off the phone.
Yeah, behind the back mouth guard, off that guy's phone.
What a shot.
Unbelievable
Amazing.
Shot.
Like Steph Curry with the towel last year.
Yeah.
No looks.
Kevin Durant is so smooth. He can lose a shoe and score. No problem. That's how smooth he is. KD is so smooth, he can lose a shoe smoothly. Look how easily it comes off.
Does he not tie his shoes?
No.
He loses a shoe every week.
He's a loosey-goosey shoe,
he really
yeah, for
is.
Sure.
He really is. Trey Kirby, you wanted to bring back the skyhook?
Oh, yeah. Can't wait.
Yeah. Clint Capella heard you. Here we go.
Ooh,
maybe we can leave it.
Yeah. Yeah, just.
Oh.
He left it definitely short.
A little short.
Yeah. sad.
In Memphis Sunday, new Wizards head coach Scott Brooks gets hammered.
In the face!
By a fan. You can't hit a guy with glasses.
Hey, that's the Joker's line.
Rough day for the Suns equipment
manager.
Can't hit
a guy with glasses.
Rough day for the Suns equipment manager. They forgot how to spell the name of one of their players. That's not how you spell Bledsoe. Yeah. That's one of their star players.
It got worse for the Suns. This is the Soul Patrol. All right, we're flipping. All right, I got it. Oh! No, Jeff. It says Jeff on the back of his jersey.
Jeff.
At least they spelled your name right, Jeff.
Come on, Jeff.
He handled it well, though. He handled it well.
His name is actually spelled G-E.
Right.
And we had a wedgie. Second one of the season. Anthony Bennett sticks it. Right there, he's on the Nets. Yes, Anthony Bennett's on the Nets. Yeah. Nets play-by-play man Ryan Rucco called it a neck ball. We prefer wedgie here on the starters.
Yeah, come on.
Number two on the season.
Great start. We're away.
I like it.
First week, we get two. That's good.
50 is definitely in play.
I think
coming for you, 50. All right, after the jump, Catwoman's very solid. Play of the night. Don't go anywhere. All right, quick look at tonight's pick'em game. It's the Bulls and the Nets. We got three guys taking the Bulls and the guy that's 1-3 taking the Nets.
Just like last year, Skeets, you're losing.
Lele, where are we going for your very solid play?
We're going to Phoenix, and it's a corker here from Draymond Green. This one's actually for John Schumann. Watch this for a beautiful bounce pass from the high post to a guy finishing for a layup. That's gorgeous. Clay didn't hit too many yesterday, but he hit this one because look at this pass. Right down the lane. Beautiful finish. That's what I call a very solid play.
Nice gloves.
Real nice.
Cover up those hairy arms. All right. Tonight, I already showed you, it's the Bulls and the Nets. It's here on the network. I got the Nets. These guys got the Bulls. Hey, man, the Nets have looked surprising.
I almost took the Nets.
Lopez Bros showdown.
They're not last year's Nets. Oh, yeah, the Lopez Bros. You're right. Absolutely. Tomorrow, guys, Fan Night is back. Doubleheader action. Rockets-Cavs gets underway at 6 p.m. Eastern because of the World Series. They bumped that up a bit. The later game is the Warriors and Blazers. Two great games there. Also tomorrow, it's the Starters Twitter show.
Oh, yeah.
Live at 11 a.m. Eastern on Twitter. We hope you join us again, 11 a.m. Lee, think we have time for a fan sign?
We do, and it comes in from Ruari and his friends in Miami at the Heat-Spurs game. And we'll show you that one tomorrow.
What a tease!
Live TV.
Thanks to the NBA store for the jersey today. Really appreciate it.
Thanks for joining, folks. And remember, Halloween comes once a year, so live it up like this guy.
Brace the day, people.